You are watching surveillance footage showing five asylum seekers who viciously attacked police officers in New York's Times Square as the cops were attempting to detain another man. Now, the assault happened last Saturday when police attempted to disperse a disorderly group of people. ABC News reports that when officers attempted to place an individual in custody, the suspects began to kick and punch the officers, and then they fled the scene. And you know, you can see all of that taking place in the surveillance footage that we just showed you. Now, luckily, no one was seriously injured, and the police were treated on the scene for minor injuries, including one person who had some cuts to his face. The suspects luckily were later arrested. The suspects were identified Wednesday as Yorman Reveron, 24 years old, Darwin Andres Gomez Iskiel, 19 years old, Wilson Jarez, 21, Kelvin Arocha, 19, and then Joan Boada, 22 years old. So they face some charges, including assault on a police officer, disorderly conduct, and gang assault. Now, it is being widely reported now by local news outlets in New York that the individuals who carried out these assaults are actually asylum seekers. The assault took place in front of a migrant shelter, and there have been increasing scuffles with migrants between one another for the most part, but this is the first time that we're seeing surveillance footage of them literally attacking cops and being kind of brazen and emboldened enough to do something like that. One of them already had a criminal record. Reveron has two pending cases in Manhattan for assault and robbery. He allegedly attacked a loss prevention officer at a Macy's department store during an alleged robbery, and also allegedly punched and bit a Nordstrom Rack employee in November. I don't want to get ahead of myself here, because I have a whole argument that I'm about to make, but let me just say this. Considering the lack of resources for migrants, considering the fact that you have a situation in which there isn't enough shelter and you have migrants sleeping outside, can we deport the migrants who are engaging in this kind of behavior and this kind of crime? Like, one of them has already gotten arrested twice for assaulting employees at retail stores, and then you have the surveillance footage of them kicking cops in the head as the cops are trying to detain another guy. Why? What are we doing? So they get arrested and then they're let out. No bail, because it's New York City, of course. Okay, this is, listen, I know we have a giant left-wing audience and I love you guys. Please don't give in to some knee-jerk reaction to provide cover for these people. These are not people you need to provide cover for. These are people who are in the country claiming asylum. They don't have a right to be here. It is a privilege to be able to take advantage of our asylum program and be able to claim asylum, claim that you're here because of whatever reason. I don't know exactly which reason they gave for their asylum claim. And you get to have your case adjudicated in front of a judge. But if you're causing all sorts of chaos, and if you're assaulting police officers, like, the idea that we're not even having a conversation about immediately deporting them is ridiculous. But then not only that, they get arrested and immediately released without bail because of bail reform in New York. That's insane, right? Am I crazy? I don't know. I feel like I've lost my mind at this point. I feel like I'm gonna get like an onslaught of ridiculous harassment because I think people seeking asylum and taking up finite resources that could be given to another asylum seeker who isn't causing problems, it's ridiculous. The Manhattan District Attorney's Office says that an investigation into the incident is ongoing. We now have additional video surveillance that was not available at the time of arraignment and are continuing to speak to witnesses in order to determine the specific role of each defendant. And by the way, I want to be clear about something. If you are part of the left and you don't speak out against incidents like that, what it does is it allows for the right to paint a picture of what all asylum seekers are like, what all migrants are like. And as we know, based on studies that have been conducted previously, there's no indication that immigrant communities have a higher rate of crime. Okay, anyone who claims that they do, it's just unfounded. There's no evidence of that. But if the left starts providing cover for migrants who do commit crime and feel emboldened enough to literally assault police officers as they're trying to detain someone else, that sends a really bad message about what the left wants to represent. And it also allows for, in my opinion, the defamation of migrants who are here who have legitimate asylum claims and should not be treated any differently from ordinary people, especially considering how vulnerable they are and how they're here either for safety or for opportunity. So this should not paint a picture of asylum seekers. But for those who cause these kinds of problems, there should be consequences and they should be deported immediately. So at least 41 people have been arrested at the Roosevelt Hotel since May. The Roosevelt Hotel in New York City has been used for migrant shelters. And apparently they've had 41 people who've been arrested. Most of those cases involve domestic violence. An asylum seeker was accused of bashing an employee in the head with a no parking sign in June after the worker basically kicked him out of the building for being unruly. The worker ended up with a 6-inch gash on his head, and Mayor Eric Adams made an unannounced visit to the hotel within days to basically survey the situation. A 30-year-old migrant at the Manhattan hotel turned shelter was also arrested for alleged child endangerment. His alleged victim was an 11-year-old daughter, and that's according to police reports on the matter. And the Manhattan District Attorney's Office later declined to prosecute because prosecuting people is tough. You need to actually prove your case. And if it's not an open and shut case, they just drop it. So a spokesperson for the Manhattan DA's office says, after thorough investigation and review of the facts, the people declined to prosecute this matter. If a crime cannot be proven beyond a reasonable doubt, it is our ethical duty not to charge it. It seems like they believe it's their ethical duty not to charge anyone with anything. So we'll see how it plays out for the people who were caught in that surveillance footage, beating the crap out of those cops. But anyone who thinks like, oh, who cares? We don't like cops, so let them do whatever they want. You're ridiculous, okay? You're ridiculous. Not all of us have the resources, as Cori Bush did, to hire private security and feel safe. Ordinary citizens have their tax money sent to local police departments for protection to keep the community safe. So if you have a situation in which police are getting the message that they can be assaulted like that, and then right after their book, they're just released without bail. I don't know, I feel like it's gonna harm recruitment efforts in a situation where we already have a shortage of police officers. So when you call the cops because you need them and they're unable to come because there is that shortage, don't complain about it if you provided cover for the kind of behavior we saw in that surveillance footage. But aside from that, if these guys are comfortable enough to openly, publicly, in broad daylight beat the crap out of police officers, what do you think they're willing to do to ordinary people? We already know one of them had no problem beating up or assaulting retail workers. So what kind of other damage are they gonna do to other members of that community? No, we gotta speak out against this stuff, and we have to speak out against it loudly. We have to be clear that they're not representative of immigrants and migrants. We also have to be clear that we on the left denounce and condemn this kind of behavior and want consequences for it. And if you don't, just think about what kind of message that sends to the general public about what the priorities and actual values of the left happen to be.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.